Hi, my name's Nick Jennison. Got a lesson for you today on how to turn your pentatonic scale into two slightly more interesting versions of itself by moving one note each time. But first, a word on the gear I'm using. This is a beautiful Shergold Masquerader. I'm playing through a PV Classic 30. I'm gonna use this Neck P90 for the majority of this lesson, but I might find my way down here under this beautiful Seymour Duncan JB in the bridge. It's gonna sound a little bit like this. So what we've got going on there are two slight optimizations of the pentatonic scale that I'm going to refer to as the Mixolydian pentatonic and the Dorian pentatonic. But you might well think of these as the Eric Johnson pentatonic, the Mixolydian one, and the Robin Ford pentatonic, the Dorian one, which puts us in some fairly esteemed company. Let's start with the Mixolydian pentatonic. It's going to look a bit like this. We're going to start with our E minor pentatonic, which will form the basis for all of this kind of stuff. I'm sure you know by now, but position one of the pentatonic scale goes like this. Now what we're going to do with this scale is we're going to take all of the thirds, which are currently minor thirds, and we're going to raise them by one semitone or one fret to turn them into major thirds. Now this is similar to the way that you would turn a minor chord into a major chord, and it's also the same way you turn a minor seven chord into a dominant seven chord, which of course is the parent chord of the Mixolydian scale. Yada, yada, yada. If you didn't come here for that, that's fine. We are done with the theory lesson for the day. So the thirds in our minor pentatonic are going to be here, which is the highest note on the E string, mirrored on the low E string, again, the highest note. And we also find one here, which is finger one, the lowest note on our G string. So to recap, and we're going to take all of those notes and shift them up by one fret, which gives us this. Now on its own, that doesn't seem to make any difference at all, but when you put it in the context of the scale, it turns this into this. Now it's a different kind of sound. I think it's a great sound. It's a little more sunny than the minor pentatonic, but not quite as jolly as the major pentatonic. Still got a little bit of an edge to it. And the beautiful thing about this is it presents us with some semitones between the fourth and the now major third, which we can do these little bends on. Allow me to demonstrate. That's kind of a cool sound that you hear guys like Ian Thornley use all the time. Steve Morse does quite a lot of it, as does the aforementioned Eric Johnson. Now you might feel that this stretch down here is a little bit of a big one. So what we can do is we can take the fourth finger note on your low E string and we can actually reposition it here on the 11th fret of the A string, which will give us this shape. Now, traditionally, you would use this over any dominant seven chord, so it's kind of useful in the blues. It sounds pretty cool. You can pretty much sneak this in anytime there's just a straight power chord going on, though. So if you're playing, for example, a rock backing track in E, or your band are jamming out just over an E power chord, you can sneak this in and make it sound all kind of interesting. Another cool place to use it is if you're playing in a minor key, you can sneak this in over the seven chord, which in this case, if I was playing in E, would be D, which gives me this kind of sound. So what I'm doing there, again, playing the key of E, is I've snuck my Mixolydian pentatonic in from the 7, which in this case is going to be D. And that's kind of a neat little way of using it, so you don't have to use it strictly from the root. It's a cool thing. Now, I did promise you two scales, so let's have a look at the second one. This is going to be, again, based on the minor pentatonic, which, to refresh your memory, will look like this. But this time, we're going to address the minor 7th interval, which we'll find here, and also here. That's gonna be the highest note on our B string and the lowest note on your D string. And what we're gonna do with these ones is flatten them. We're gonna move them down by one semitone, which will give you this kind of sound. And to my ear, that's kind of very characteristically Dorian. On its own, it can be a little jarring, but it's really cool if you throw this in around your existing minor pentatonic licks. Might sound something like this. for the sound of that one in a minor key, it's basically outlining the major four chord, which is a very characteristic Dorian kind of sound. But it doesn't just have to be in a minor key. You can use this, for example, in a 12-bar blues, where you might play the mixed Lydian pentatonic over chord number one, because it's a dominant seven chord. And then you might play the Dorian pentatonic, again from E, but you play that over chord number four, which gives you a way of navigating those changes. And if you're feeling really experimental, you can even try playing the mixed Lydian pentatonic from B over the 5 chord. And that might give us something a little bit like this. Alright, so that's two little optimizations we can make to our pentatonic scale, which is going to give you some musical and interesting results for comparatively little effort, which is always nice. I'm going to leave you there. I've got loads more creative type guitar lessons coming up for you very, very shortly, but for the time being, I'm going to sign off. My name's Nick Jennison. I'll see you next time.